Guys, what it's a pizza V again with another episode of Sakura Card Captor and the Clear Cards. You know, I was kind of worried I wasn't able to see this episode because things happened, but I'm glad that I was able to so I can review this for you guys. So on the sixth episode is Sakura the Rabbit and the Song of the Moon. Yay! For the first time. I mean, for a second, I thought it was Yukito because, yeah, Yukito is called Snow Rabbit, so, yeah. Today we have another relaxing episode. Well, that tap with a foot, it's a really obvious reference. Well, anyway, the episode starts with Sakura going out for shopping. As she passes by the Sakura tree, yes, there are no Sakuras anymore, but you can tell that reference pretty obviously. That is, if you watched the first series. If you didn't, you don't know what I'm talking about. This reminds Sakura of the flower viewing that she had with her friends a few episodes away. I mean, that episode, it was last episode, but still for the anime, probably it's days. Especially the time she spent with Shaoran that day. Kira-chan pops out with envy that she didn't take him with her. Well, for obvious reasons, Chiharu, Yamazaki, Naoko, Akiho, they can see you, Kira. You know, I feel kind of bad or ashamed, whatever you want to say, because even Sakura and Kira have a freaking smartphone. I don't. Yeah, I don't own a smartphone. I have a dumb phone for calls and messages. It still reads MP3, so I'm okay with that. Anyway, as they talk, Sakura and Kero-chan cross by Akiho. She's out for shopping, but she's still new in town, so she doesn't know where to go, and Sakura offers herself to go with her. Well, look at that! Akiho also has a plushie bunny. Starting to get more and more suspicious, just saying. Hey, leave me in the comments down below, what do you think? I've seen some quote-unquote spoilers, that's not official, it's just theory still. But what do you think? When Sakura returns home, her dad is taking care of some paperwork for school. Yay! Hey Dad, so you're gonna stay for dinner? Yes, I will, but I will return to school after. Okay. After a small chit-chat with her dad, Mei Ling calls her. Yay, I miss her so much! Well, guess what? We have a funny moment between them, Kero, Mei Ling, and Sakura. Giving Kero, like, the chance of becoming Keroberge? Or is it Seroberge? Honestly, I can't tell anymore. But I miss the big kitty. Honestly, this is better than Yamazaki, just saying. Well, let's just hope that Mei Ling indeed returns for the summer break. When Sakura is taking dinner with her family and chatting, she hears a sound. This sound for some reason transports her to the dreamland. The mysterious person is there once again. This time it feels like they want to tell something. Not sure why, but does not say. Of course. On the second part of the episode, Sakura meets up with Tomoyo at the usual place so they can go together to school. Hey, she brought Kero with her. Making a promise to Akiho that she brought the bunny and she brought Kero. In class, they briefly speak about premonitions, to a book they are reading. This recalls Sakura when she met Shaoran, Mizuki, and Ariel. Are they dreams? Or are they predictions of the future? She ponders. On lunch break, Tomoyo invites the girls and Shaoran to go to the music club. Tomoyo invites Akiho to sing along with her. Because, yes, Tomoyo noticed you sang with her, Akiho. After the support from Sakura and Chiharu, she decides to sing along with Tomoyo with Shaoran playing the piano. After this song, Sakura once again hears this sound. Looks very familiar, but what? After realizing this, Shoran asks Tomoyo if they can keep the room. She nods and pushes Chiharu and Akiho to the door so they can register Akiho to the chorus club. Shoran asks what is she hearing. She says, "Looks like Tomoyo's old camera." So like, old static. After looking around, Sakura spots the card. This is it. She captures it. No drama was involved this time, which was good. She calls the key, releases it, and secures it. It's the record card. Yay! Shoran is feeling bad. She didn't hear it. She didn't feel it. And nothing. These cards are clear to them. Get it? I made a pun there. Sorry for that. But honestly, deep inside, I feel sorry for Shoran. Yeah, that's the episode for today, guys. I'm really glad that I was able to review this because I was kind of afraid that I couldn't because the website I was looking at, I believe it was taken down. So yeah, I think I will have to see it with another ways. But regardless, guys, what do you think who Akiho is? I've seen some theories which I think they might be correct. And I know we are just not even two hands full. It's like one hand full and one finger episodes, but you know how we fans are. We start to do theories and what ifs and maybes, and I want to know what you guys think. Who is Akiho? Who is that plushie? Is she a captor too? Akiho card captor? Is she? Let me know in the comments down below. What do you think, guys? Once again, thanks a lot for watching, guys. Make sure you like, comment, share with people that may enjoy. And if you're not a subscriber already, please hit that bell button and that subscribe button so you won't miss any video of mine, either is drawing or reviews. I don't know. I've been very, very busy with my gaming channel. So you can check that out too on the description down below. Once again, guys, thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you on my next video. And like always, take care.